like your season of occupation. It's time to send in your application. Get to know your short-term friends. We only talk to till summer ends. The best way to spend.
Hi, my name is Sophia Santos, and welcome to another study vlog. Today, I bring you along with me as I study for my prelims. I want to make these types of videos into some kind of a diary or an archive where I study and also talk about my life and realizations in the background. I love making videos like these, but I also want to bring more substance into it, so here's me trying. I hope you enjoy. Good morning. Today is February 22, 2 days before my prelims exams, and we are going to do a lot of studying. Here's my bag full of everything I need. For studying, I just have my keyboard, my iPad, of course, my bullet journal, some random note-taking paper, an iPad stand, my charger, and my favorite pens. This is just my everyday studying setup. I have my pens over here, my bullet journal, my iPad, my keyboard, and usually something to drink. First task is to internalize and fix my schedule. I honestly haven't been the best with keeping up with exams and deadlines lately. More than ever, I feel like the fatigue that comes with online classes is hitting me this sem. That means a lot of cramming and a lot of last-minute studying, which is never good for my grades and for my mental health. I'm still trying to get used to the setup all over again, if there is such a thing as getting used to it, but one way I try to combat this is by planning and journaling, which is what I'm doing right now. I feel like it's important to remind yourself that it's fine to not feel your best all the time and to not be your best all the time, as long as you're trying. I know we've been in quarantine for a whole year, but it doesn't really get easier, so remember to be kind to yourselves. So our to-do list for today is to review and take notes for my Filipino class and to finish editing my PE video. If I have a little bit more time, I can also catch up on my lectures for my HRM class. So yeah. Second task is to review for my Filipino exam. I just have my professor's PowerPoint on one side and I put my written notes on the other, just like this. This class has been really good to me. I feel like I'm actually learning something I have to learn, and our activities and exams don't feel unnecessary, which I think is what everything else feels like. Don't get me wrong, it's not because my profs suck or anything, it's just that it's so hard to find purpose into learning now. The more it feels forced, the less motivated I get. So it's just getting more difficult for me to find inspiration. This sem is harder for me compared to the previous ones, but in a good way, I guess. I feel like I've been floating before into a sea of terminologies where I have to memorize this and memorize that, or honestly, just look for answers on my notebook. But this time, I have profs that actually challenge us to think, and I love that, but not so much because I'm not used to it anymore. It's harder to maintain good grades, and I just hope that I don't feel tired of studying and learning after this pandemic, because honestly, it's so freaking exhausting. Time check. It is already 3:50 p.m. and I finished taking my notes for Filipino, but before I start reviewing them, I'm just going to quickly make a thumbnail for a YouTube video that I'll be posting around 4 to 4:30 p.m. today. So I'll just show the process here. Doing YouTube, editing, and making thumbnails has really been helping me maintain a school-life balance. When you're doing everything at home, it's so easy to be immersed in doing one thing. I don't want my whole freaking year to just be studying and having my grades as my only accomplishment. It doesn't only disrupt my creativity, but also my growth as a person rather than just a student. So I'm thankful for having a creative outlet. It has inspired me to do some of my projects more creatively, and I love that because I enjoy doing them more. Here's some kind of an example. Before the sun disappears, I just have to film a quick clip for my PE video. Pero dapat ganito siya. Hi, my name is Sofia Santos and welcome to my journey after Roomba. Today is February 19, the day of my final video, so I put on a cute dress, put on my shoes, and started dancing. Well, kind of. What I want. Be wondering how I got so good without experience. Well, the answer is I didn't. Now let's backtrack a little bit. Okay, that's it. I honestly have no idea why I'm showing you this, so back to reviewing. Actually going on right now, so we're just going to listen to that. During online classes, I swear I try my best to keep my focus, and I do that by annotating or writing down notes. But that doesn't happen all the time though. I feel like I got too used to the fact that my lectures are recorded and I can watch them some other time, which makes me really, really lazy. But I promise to try harder. After my classes, I like to take a break from staring at my gadgets and do something physical. This has slowly been helping me with sleep because I get more tired at night from actually doing something tiring during the day. So, work out with me? It's already 7:50 p.m. and I'm about to start answering my Filipino exam, but I'm afraid the video is going to end here. I hope you guys enjoyed it somehow, and if you did, make sure to click thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I make videos like this every week, and if you guys have any video ideas or video suggestions, you can comment them down below and I'll make sure to take note of them. And that's it. Thank you so much for being here, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!
1, 2, 3, funk it.